Hello everybody, how's it going? This is DJ Super J. I'm going to do a couple FL tutorial videos, or I'm just going to do one and see how people respond to it. See if it's any good. If it is, I'll continue. If it's not, I'll stop and go cry in a corner. So, alright, so this is for first time FL users. This is for people who have just bought the program, just got it, however they got it, and they've just opened it, and they're going, what the hell am I supposed to do? This is weird. There's a lot of buttons. There's a lot of menu options. There's a lot of crazy stuff here that I can do. And it's too much for my head. So I need some help. I need to find something. And I know that when I first started, I was the same way, and I couldn't find anything on any of these subjects. So I had to go up myself. And I'm just going to show you to do, because I remember being there and I remember what it was like. So here we go. When you first open FL, you're going to see four windows. This is FL Studio 8. I don't know which one you have. If you have 8, this is what you'll see. I don't know if you'll see anything different than 7. I'm pretty sure 7 doesn't have the fruity limiter, but we're not even going to worry about these things at the beginning here. So what you want to do when you first open FL this first time is you close this limiter if you're an 8, and close the mixer, which will probably open for all FL versions. So what you want to do now is, after you've closed those, now you see these two windows. There's the playlist, and they don't give you a name, but it's actually called the step sequencer. Now I'll tell you what these do, excuse me. Now, so these interact with every sample that you have on your computer. By default, FL installs samples to your computer when you first install the program. That's going to be located in this window on the left here. It's kind of like expandable, closable little scroll menu here. So what you want to look for is under data, sorry, under packs, you want to go, and you'll see there's a bunch of loops. There's drum loops, there are synthesizers, there are basses, there are all sorts of samples. If you click on them, you can hear them. Pretty much hear what you're doing before you put it on. So, the point of the beginning of the first time is to just familiarize yourself with everything. So, pretty much each folder in here is expandable. You know, there are different samples there. Okay, so let's say you found a sample that you like and you want to test it out and see if you can make some sort of beat with it or something, just to, you know, familiarize yourself. So we'll take, how about we do, don't pay attention to this at all, please. I'm going to just do this. Okay, so let's say you found a sample that you want. So we're going to put the kick here. You can just drag it and drop it. That's all you have to do. You just drag and drop like that. Pick up, drag it over to the sample box here, and let go. And if there aren't any samples on here, let me show you. You can still do the same thing. Just have a completely blank. And it's going to say sampler, but you just drag it, and you put it on top of that, and then if you want to drag another one below that, you just put it right below and it'll appear there as its own channel that you can put the steps on. So basically, okay, so basically this part here is where you create all of your loops. So let's say you want a simple loop here. So I'm preferable to trance or techno, so I'm going to try that first. So let's get something here. Let me just create something real quick. It's simple and easy to listen to and easy to do. And it's pretty much the most simple kind of beat you could possibly have. Okay, so now you've done that. Now, when you're at this point, you'll want to test it out, see if it works. See if you, it sounds right. So you hit the play button up here. This will play the pattern that you're on. This is a pattern. Okay? We'll get to that in a little bit. All right. So you hit play. Simple enough, but it sounds good. So you like that sample, right? Okay. Let's say you want to create a file of that, an MP3. Because you just made something and you want to show your friends. Say, oh, cool, look, I made something in FL Studio 8. Come check it out. Even though it might be shitty, yeah, great, here, take a look. I can do it. So this is where it gets confusing a little bit if you're not paying attention. What you want to do is you see this window over here, this playlist. This controls the song structure. Now the song structure will combine all your patterns into one giant to one giant collaboration of all of them. So for example, if you think of this as a pattern, this is a pattern of notes. Now in pattern one, that's just this pattern is one, and we can identify this by up here, see next to this tempo, don't worry about what that is for now, but next to here there's this pattern number, and you can change that to two. So now see in playlist it's on pattern two, and if you put bars in there it will play those bars for pattern 2 for as many as you tell it to play. So let's go back to pattern 1. So pattern 1's here, right? And you want this to play more than however long it plays, more than 2 seconds. So in pattern 1, let me just resize this. In pattern 1, you'll want to place a bar here. So that will be one count of this pattern. So it'll be going one time. So now, here's how you listen to the playlist rather than this step sequencer here. There's this next to this play button, there's this pattern light and the song light. Click on that song light and now you'll see little sliders appeared over this that you can go back and forth over. If there's more samples here, you can go over the entire playlist and select where you want to start playing. So yeah, that's the selector between listening to what your pattern is here and what the entire song sounds like. So now, if we hit play, it will show you it's playing in the step sequencer, and it will show you that it's playing in the playlist. But it's playing more than just this pattern. It's also playing everything else, even though you have nothing selected here. So let's just make another pattern here. We'll have something simple like something like this. Let's take a ride here, and we'll make it this. So we'll first listen to it in the pattern before we listen to it in the song by hitting the pattern button here and hitting play. And you can see on the playlist how it shows you when it plays by this little light here. Turns on every time the sound comes from that pattern. So we have that now. So we'll go back to the song button and we'll add this pattern with the pattern 1. So pattern 1 and pattern 2 are now functioning simultaneously in the song menu, in the playlist. So let's hit play and listen to that. Now as you can see, they're playing together. Pretty cool, huh? So now you understand that, and that's a really key part of FL Studio, is to understand that the patterns can be connected and you can place them everywhere. I mean, you can place them in each of its slot and you can alternate them. So if I take them out like this, by the way, I didn't tell you this, clicking left is to add this bar and right clicking is to deselect it. I'm sorry, I should have said that. Alright, so anyway, on to that. So I can rotate these like this, and it's off, back on again, and off, back on again, and off, and so on and so forth. You can play around with that a lot. You can add as many patterns as you desire. It goes all the way down to 999, which I'm hope to God you don't have to do that someday, because that's a lot of work. So now here, that's the final step of the tutorial here tonight, or today, or wherever you are, is how to export your track to a MP3 or WAV file that you can share with your friends, or upload to a label, or if you know it, whatever you want to do, share it with people. So here's how to go about this. Make sure that song is selected, because it will render whatever light is selected here. So if you select pattern, it will only render that single pattern out of all the patterns you have. But if you select song, it will render everything in the playlist window that is on here, on the bars that are there that you've wanted to play. So what we'll do is select song, we'll go to File, and we'll go to Export. Now here you can select, you know, MIDI file, OGG file, MP3, or WAV. I'm going to select MP3. I'm going to save it to my desktop and call it, you know what, I'll save it to my documents and call it Test MP3. Let me hit Save. And now here you have this little window where you can select your bit rate of your MP3. That's basically the quality. Higher the quality, the larger the disk space. If you can see, if the lowest quality will take up 108 kilobytes, whereas the highest quality will take up 1.5 megabytes. So basically, if you want to share with your friends, and if it's a long song, probably, I mean, this song is only about 20 seconds, you know, if your song is 30 seconds, if your song is like 5 or 10 minutes, maxing out that quality is going to make it probably really big, around maybe 50 megabytes. So if you want to share with your friends, I recommend 192 to 224. That usually leaves it in a good place, so I'm going to select that. Now the looping mode, this will tell you, this will actually let you do three things. Leave remainder means let the song play all the way out, even if the playlist finishes here at bar 17 here, even at bar 17. So allow the sound to go further. If we cut remainder, it would cut right at 17 when the sound stopped immediately. When the playlist was finished, it would stop the sound. But if there's some remaining sound that's longer than the actual playlist here, then it will continue onward. And you don't really need to worry about wrap. I wouldn't recommend using it. I don't use it. The depth, it's only for wave. We're doing MP3 this time. Let's not worry about that. I'll do that another thing. Sampler interpolation. Basically, I know that 512 is the best quality and that it gets all of the sounds properly. I'd recommend doing 128 to 256 because 512, well, on this size of a song it doesn't matter, but on a large song it really matters and it would be very slow. You should use 512 as your final rendering, your final save, because that takes a long time for some computers. If yours is slower, mine is considerably fast, but if yours is slower, you should use 128 or 256. I'm going to stick with 512. As you can see, it tells you that it's slow as hell. But don't worry about that right now. And we won't worry about any of these things. We'll talk about that later. And basically, you hit start. It will render the track, tell you percentage. And when it's done, it will close the window. And then you can see, if we go to my documents, it's right here, test MP3. And let's play it. And there you are, it's come out of the playlist, and it's now in an MP3 that you can share with your friends. And I hope that's helped you to just get introduced to the program and understand a little bit about FL and how it works. And hopefully this will really help you to create some much better stuff than I've created here and shown you. And hopefully there will be more tutorials in the future if people like this. Thank you very much.